I'm John Reynolds.
I'm Luke Shandy.
And I'm Luis Sanchez.
And we're here today for our final public engagement project. We decided to venture into something that we didn't even know existed until last week.
Fair enough.
The Lyon County History Center. Here you will see a news brief of what they do, what they're about, and in what ways they would like to engage with the community. Check it out.
Can I know your names and occupations, please?
Hi, I'm Greg Jordan, and I'm the Executive Director of the Lyon County Historical Society.
And I am Lisa Soller, and I am the Curator, Exhibit Manager, and Education Coordinator, and whatever else he throws at me.
Great. Can you guys explain to us a little bit about what is the Lyon County Historical Society?
The Lyon County Historical Society was founded in 1937, its primary purpose is to preserve the history of Lyon County, Kansas. When we were initially chartered, we were part of the State Historical Society. We were that way for 3 years, and then we became our own entity. As time has marched on, we are now in our new building. We will always be the Lyon County Historical Society, but the new building is the Lyon County History Center. Again, still maintaining our original job, which is to maintain Lyon County history, the stories and the artifacts and the archives that make up that history. It's a job that we are the only ones doing. So if we don't do it, that history is lost and lost forever. So it's an incredibly important job to have. I, as the executive director, try to find the funding to provide for my experts to do their job. And one of my experts is Lisa, who does most everything here, but her main job is being curator, and that is to maintain the artifacts.
Thank you very much for that answer. Can you tell us what is you guys' targeted audience, like what kind of communities you guys help, and what are these communities?
Well, Lisa, would you like to take that one?
Well, as far as the target audience, we definitely want, well, I mean, we have different audiences. We certainly want to be here for the county residents, and because it is their history, it's their stories. But then we also have educational opportunities for students. We want to create an environment for families to be able to come, senior citizens, millennials. We really don't have a set group that we target. We want to be able to share these stories with as many people as possible. So anywhere from the county residents to travelers that are passing through to people that are here for the many events that we have here in Emporia, which is, you know, the DK 200 and the Glass Blown Open with the disc golf and just anybody traveling through. So we're here for them, but then our programming is where we start getting a little more, where we narrow it to the different demographics.
If I may, one thing that we'd like to change is our demographic to some respect. We do not attract younger people in the numbers that we think we should be able to. In particular, high school and university age individuals. A lot of people come to school, they're obviously not from this area. A lot of them don't care about the history of this area. They're just here to go to school, and we understand that. But some students do like to know the environment in which they live in. And so we want to open our door better for those students to come and interact with us. And our feeling is that if we can get you interested in history at whatever age it is, that you will continue that interest for your lifetime. And so it's self-serving, obviously, to expand our horizons, but also it helps the individual know more about where they are and what's happened here before.
And we've started to actually address those that age group, the demographic that Greg was talking about, with the high school students and the university students, by creating a membership level that especially for that group, it's $10 a year. And it gets them free admission to the museum, discount in the gift shop, so they can send things home. If they do live, if their hometown is far away, they can send stuff home. But also the programming. So we want to do more programming that appeals to that age group and to get their input. I mean, and that's so important to us. We want to make sure we're capturing these stories and telling these stories, but the programming is what the people want. It's easy for me to put an exhibit up and to create a program, but if it's not something that people want, then I shouldn't be doing it. So we really want to tailor it to the different groups as well.
Thank you. And I think you have answered this question a little bit in a way, but I also want to know more specifically, if there's any way, how do you serve, like what are more specifically the activities that you do for these communities that you already mentioned, and you know, these groups that you have talked to us about? Like,
well, yeah, the activities go with there's a lot of different reasons, the reasoning behind the activities. So an activity that we do in Emporia may not necessarily work in Reading or Red Americas or that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. So we do have to tailor our program to the audience in which we will be giving it to. We are the best thing that we do for our public is to provide knowledge. The stories, we really are storytellers. So that we tell the stories of the people and the places and the events that have happened before. And even though it's a cliche about not knowing where you're going until you know where you've been, it's certainly true. History is a very important part of all of our lives. All of us have last names, and that those last names represent a long history. And so people should be aware that history is not always boring. Oftentimes it's quite entertaining. You have to give it a chance.
We all have stories. I mean, all of us. And even an object has a story behind it and is connected with the people. You know, to be a little more specific with some of the things that we want to do is we have a children's area, the Loretto Langley Kids Zone. Mm-hmm. We would like to create programming that centers around that. Our book nook has books that reflect our core themed exhibits, which is natural history, Native Americans, immigration, transportation, farming, ranching, business and industry, and military. So we have books in the kids area that reflect that. Well, we're taking it one step further, and we will have books in Braille. We'll have books on audiobooks on a tablet for auditory learners. We'll have books in Spanish and Chinese and different languages. But then we want to flip that and then look at what is the folklore, what stories are coming out of these different countries, and have those stories in English. Mm-hmm. Then in that kids area, we also wanted to take a day, maybe once a month, every couple of months, and have it for special needs children. So we really want to be inclusive. We want accessibility for everyone, and we want to change what we've done. You know, like Greg said, we've been around since 1937, and a lot of our exhibits and programming has centered around pioneers and European settlement, and we want to change that. We want to be part of the conversation. We want to incite conversation. He was talking about the history. History is not always pretty. It's not always unicorns and jelly beans. It really is. There's some bad stuff. I mean, and it's happening today. And so to turn it, and how is history related to the current events that's happening? How did we get to where we're at? And what can we learn from history to focus on what's happening and bring it full circle. So that's some of the things we want to do.
One of the stories we really need to tell is, unless we're Native Americans, we're a nation of immigrants. Mm-hmm. And all of our people came from someplace else. And so what is a typical reaction is, once you get here and established, then you don't want anybody else to come. So this happened to a lot of, and each group that came after that were ostracized. It happened to the Italians, Irish. It happened to the Irish, it happened to the Polish, it happened to a lot of different groups. There's a lot of that going around today with people from Latinos and Latinas, and Muslims, of course. And so we tend to forget that we all came from someplace else. Mm-hmm. And I don't view the America as a melting pot. I don't expect us all to melt and become one particular unit. I think more of us as a salad. Each of us brings something to the taste. Mm-hmm. All of us are individually important. Together we are even more important. Mm-hmm. And so that's my particular opinion, that I, as an American, are not any more important than someone from Panama. Mm-hmm. That we are all God's children. All right. So that's just my opinion.
And so we can, and that's the thing we can do here. We can explore culture. We can explore community. We want people to be able to come here and hang out and go beyond the exhibits and have discussions. In a world that, we're attached to our phone, we've lost the ability to converse with each other. Mm-hmm. And, or our conversation is, narrowed down to
smiley face
and
candy cane.
Yeah, and a candy, yeah, I mean, or it's down to 140 characters. So mm-hmm. that's why we see us as doing much more than history, but really concentrating on a community as a whole.
Community as a whole. That's really the what we want to be. Community as a whole.
All right. Well, thank you very much for your very, very good comments and answers.
Well, thank you for having
us. Thank you.